And we are back with Chef Matthew Statham. Let's chat about the World Food Championships. For those who don't know, what is it and how did you get involved in competing in that?
It is the world's largest food competition. So basically, it's just a collection. There was around 400 teams or so this year, spread across 10 categories from, you know, various states all over the world. It's basically just a chance to just come together and have fun, because it's really a really like a family. But, you know, we're competing. I mean, you want to win, but everybody, you know, it's a really good spirited competition. I actually had a we won a competition last year called the Great Slider Showdown by Made South in Franklin, Tennessee. So when we won that, part of the prize was we got a ticket to compete to the World Food Championships.
Oh, wow.
Well, through, you know, we actually had a tie when we won the Great Slider Showdown, and we had one slot. And so instead of picking between the two of us, they asked if we would defer a year. So we backed up a year. So instead of competing last year, instead of competing in 2018, we competed in 2019. But I have a buddy who ended up being on my cook team, Dan Navarro, who qualified in 2018. And he's like, hey, do you want to come be my sous chef? And I was like, yeah, you know, it's a good opportunity. I get to, it was in Orange Beach at the time. So you get to go to the, you know, you get to go to the beach for a week.
So, and so this thing is billed as the largest culinary competition in the world. And then you win this thing, right?
Well, we won our category. So we basically have 10 categories. So we were in the chef category, which is kind of the wild card. Like, hey, you may make this, you may make anything else. But so we won our category. We'll actually go to Indianapolis in May, and the 10 category winners will all pare down until there's just one person left.
Is that what they call the final table round?
Yeah, that's what their final table will be. And it's in it's been rotating cities, but we're doing Indianapolis this year.
Do you know, have they set a date for it yet so we can let our viewers know?
Yeah, hold on a second. I gotta look at this. It's the first or second week of May. I've got it written down because I'm not great on memory.
And while
it's the 7th through the 10th of May.
7th through the 10th of May. And so, and I understand that the purse is like $100,000, eh?
Yeah, the first prize in that would be 100 grand, but we will have to get through 9 other really talented chefs to do it. So I think it's going to be a lot of fun, but it's going to be a big challenge.
Got it. Now, you've got a lot of other events coming up this year. Tell us a little bit about the 38 Wine Festival.
We're doing that actually as the store. We're going as Sauce Barbecue. They have an event that's like beers, bourbon, and butts. Mm-hmm. And so it's focused on regional barbecue. We're going to go down there and make what we call our pork and greens. It's our most popular dish on the menu. And it's just basically kind of, you know, in Birmingham, you know, and to an extent, maybe a little farther in Alabama, we have, you know, pretty strong reach. But we, you know, as when you get outside of the state, a lot of people don't know who we are. Mm-hmm. And so this is just kind of a step in expanding that footprint, just to be like, hey, you know, this is pretty good. When you're in Birmingham, come see us, and, you know, maybe open some doors as far as maybe expanding the brand.
30A is booming. It is booming.
Oh, yeah.
Now, you're also going to be featured chef in the Made South Southern Whiskey Society event in Franklin. Is that what you were mentioning earlier, or were two different
things? It's the same people. So we actually started first competition with them. Chris Thomas, who's the founder, was a big fan of Saul's. He sent me a message, was like, hey, would you be interested in doing this? It's an idea. And, you know, so we established a relationship there, and, you know, I've done a couple things with them since. You know, they're really good people. They're highlighting Southern makers and, you know, what makes the South great. And so that really appeals to me, not just professionally, but personally. And so he sent him, you know, he was like, hey, we'd like to, you know, feature you in doing this. And I figured it's a great opportunity just to, you know, show out a little bit.
Now, you're, from what I understand, you're going to be joining up with what I think is a barbecue team from Australia for some competitions after the World Food Championship.
That's
final
correct.
Table, right?
We're actually, as a result of that Made South, we ended up hooking up with the guys at Golden's Cast Iron over in Columbus, Georgia. They make cast iron Kamado grills. So think big green egg, but it's made completely out of cast iron.
Okay.
I actually won one of those as part of the slider competition. And so we've been playing around on that, you know, and I've established a good relationship with them. And we built a smoker, actually, that has my buddy Dave, who got me the job at Saul's. They built us a custom smoker, and it has two of the Goldens on it. So it's just kind of a, hey, do you want to come to Memphis and they're tied in with the guys at the barbecue company in Australia. And so he's coming, and then we're kind of make a conglomeration of team to go to Memphis in May.
I mean, what do you know about, I mean, do the Aussies do barbecue any different than anywhere else?
That's a good question. I've talked to Rohan, he's our guy at, on the Smoking Jokers. He just says there's really a big void there. So it's just one of those things that he's trying to spread because he fell in love with American barbecue. And so he's, you know, trying to spread it through. So I don't know if we'll be doing anything too crazy, but we'll see.
Yeah, no Vegemite barbecue. And will you be doing some cooking classes and pop-ups in Australia with them?
We're hopefully. So with all this, with the, you know, with the relationship of all this domino that's come, we should be trying to go do some stuff probably in winter here, summer there. So probably the end of this year is kind of the plan.
What about teaching other people to cook? Is that something that you've got in the mix?
It's just, it's by default, you know, like once you start cooking, people are like, hey, show me how to do this, show me how to do that. And once you overcome like the, it's just me, you know, cause you kind of, when you start out, it's like, oh, well, I kind of know how to cook some. People are like, oh, well, you're doing great. You won this. And it's like, well, okay. So it's definitely learned for me. Like, I don't know that was something that I originally set out to do, but when I've done it a few times, I've loved it cause you get great feedback and, you know, people just want to learn, and you can just show like, hey, you don't, when we went back to where we talked about overcomplicating, it's like, just keep this simple, do what you know how to do, start with good ingredients, and people are like, oh, you know, and it kind of, you know, you kind of have a light go off in your head.
Matthew, thank you so much for being on the show. Again, everyone, it's Chef Matthew Statham.
Thank you.